Suddenly, the figures surge out of the clock toward you. Intense pressure strikes your head like a steel spike. Then everything goes black. Oops. And we make a note. What the hell happened? Oh, these are the figures. Where are we? Clock Fathom.
Yes, now.
Huh. Kamose, Villon, and Divia something or other. Diviaticu. Hail, Villon. The three figures before you are disoriented. They don't even seem to notice you at first. All three of them have a tattoo like yours. Castoffs. What befell us? Kamose? The woman is dressed in powerful-looking armor. Her face bears several scars, yet her eyes have the innocence of a child. Did he do something? Are we still in the clock? She thinks, what new torture does the changing god have for us? Diviaticu says, I do not believe so. The second figure is tall, dressed all in black. Its height is exaggerated further by a violet, fish-like crest on the top of its head. Its large yellow eyes are squinted, scanning all around. There was a woman outside the clock, but it wasn't... Villon says, it was her. The third figure points at you. He is small, wiry, and tense, as though he expects danger. He carries a shield on his back. She's a Castoff, he says, looking at your tattoo. Can't say I recognize her, though. I wish I could zoom in, but I can't when I'm in the dialogue here. Who are you? The woman steps forward. We beg your forgiveness, friend, sister. We have been through quite the trial. I am Kamose. These are my friends. The Diviaticu and Villon. We are Castoffs like you. That's one hell of a word name there. She looks you up and down, her brow slightly furrowed despite her kind demeanor. Villon says, we were ingested into your head. I saw it. How is that possible? He eyes you suspiciously. Who are you? I'm a Castoff like you. I'm the latest one. Gold and silver raise a tiny amount. The latest? Kamose raises one eyebrow significantly higher than the other. That's not possible. We faced a changing god mere days ago, and you are not the body he wore. Villon says, I think we might have been trapped in that clock for centuries, Kamose. Something about it messed with our perception. Diviaticu, the Vargellan, looks up at the city ceiling, or where the ceiling would be if there were one. Time is an illusion. How long is the right question? Is the wrong question? I'm getting tired. I'm sorry, guys. It turns its enormous, bulbous eyes to you. What is this place? Where are we? And he thinks, outside time we were, perhaps still are. Somewhere in my mind, I think. The Vargellan shuts its eyes, six nostrils open wide as it inhales deeply. Yes, perhaps you are right. Consciousnesses were ripped from our bodies when the changing god activated his clock. Then when you appeared, it happened again. Our minds ripped from their chronal prison. It looks to its friends. I cannot be certain, but I believe this to be some sort of vast mental construct. He turns to you. You're a mental construct. Villon's eyes become nearly as large as the Vargellan's. What? You mean we just went from one prison to another? He grips you by the shoulders. You did this. If this is your mind, then let us out. Why did the changing god trap you in the clock? Ah, yes, Kamose looks down, embarrassed. The three of us once worked alongside our sire. helping him with his research after he'd brought the Order of Truth to the Sagus Clefs. We saw him for what he was. Selfish. Arrogant. She thinks, Marilel helped us to see. I wonder what has become of her since we were imprisoned. Villon says, he doesn't care about us. Not a single one of our children. He crosses his arms and looks away bitterly. All of his projects were always about him. He didn't care if anyone got hurt in the process. Diviaticu says, we betrayed him. Unlike the others, the Vargellan looks you directly in the eye. We meant to stun him, to capture him before he could escape to another body, but he was too quick for us. He activated the clock, tearing our minds from our bodies and trapping us eternally. I don't know how to get out of here. Kamose says, relax, friend sister. Whether for days or centuries we survived that clock, we will survive this. If time is an illusion, then it is not our enemy. We will find a way. Why can't you get us out of here? Villon says, weren't you listening? We were trapped in that clock for centuries. I am looking for a way out, believe me. But if Diviaticu says it's your mind, then it's your show. Kamose says, so long as we live, there is hope. One of us will find a way. Let me look around. I'll be back. Don't give up hope, friend, sister. Alright, I got a better look at these guys. Oh, yeah. There was another one like this at the execution, the guy with the fin. Alright, we're gonna look around. I'm not seeing anything.
On it. Ready.
Okay, I'm looking around.
Fine.
The three of them mutter to each other, looking around this strange place as they try to find another way out. Well met, sister, Kamose says. Have you discovered anything new about our predicament? I don't see any way out. The Vargellan stretches its neck, putting its face within a handspun of yours. Handspan. It seems to be examining you, and it says, your mind. Only you have the power to change. Kamose says, what he's trying to say is that this place was created for your body, or perhaps by your body. Our sire placed within each of us unique gifts and abilities. For example, I have never heard tell of another Castoff who could trap consciousnesses the way you have. She gives you a warm smile. He would not have created the space for you without also giving you a means by which to move through it. Think, what other gifts did our Creator bestow upon you? I'm what they call a nano. He laughs. So's the Vargellan, but you just don't see him barking about it. Kamose says, you see, that's just the type of thing that you do. It was a path you chose, not something our sire gave you, nor a means to freedom. I chose an aspect of myself when I was born, deep in the heart of this labyrinth. Is that it? Diviaticu shakes his head. I can see what you speak of, it says, and you get a momentary impression that its eyes can see through you. This aspect describes you, just as I am Vargellan. Villon is observant. Kamose is foolish. I object to that characterization, Kamose says. Villon gives a kind chuckle. He's not wrong, and you know it. At her wounded look, he raises his hands placatingly. It's the truth. Anyway, you've gotten us out of twice as much trouble as you get us into. The Vargellan speaks to you. These aspects are descriptors of who we are, but they are not us. That you chose your aspects says quite a lot, but I do not believe that is enough to set us free. I built a path out of a deep fathom in my mind by recovering memories I had lost. Perhaps, Diviaticu says, if there are any memories here to recover. Villon curls his lip and looks around. Maybe I just don't know what memories look like, but I don't see anything. It would seem we are in agreement, then. I don't think I have the ability you're talking about. You must! Kamose looks at her companions and back to you. We each have our gifts, given to us by our sire for a specific purpose. His purpose, of course, but a purpose nonetheless. She presses a hand to her chest. They say, for example, that, foolish though I may be, I have 9 magical gifts of speech. That is not something I chose nor learned, but it is who he made me to be. Villon rubs his hand along the edge of his shield. I am a master of defensive arts. Our sire learned them when he was in my body. Probably built my body to excel at it. I wouldn't call it a gift, but it's me, yeah. Diviaticu says, I am one with the shadows. I live in them. I breathe them. This is not some esoteric I discovered, but a unique ability our sire chose for me while he was in my body. Kamose gives you a kind smile. The gift is in you. Perhaps you have just forgotten. Our sire wouldn't have made this place for you without granting you the power to get out. Focus. Find the answer inside yourself. Okay. So shut your eyes. Search for memories. Search your memories for this ability they speak of. You rifle through your memories, past everything you actually remember, to those memories you didn't create yourself. There must be a key or a door, anything that would help you to escape this fathom of your mind. Just as you're about to give up, you find something, a cluster of sparks, nascent abilities deep within the core of your being. You sense the abilities to speak eloquently, to use a shield with a master skill, to lurk among the shadows as though they were home.
I'm ready to learn something new.
You just gained 100 XP. Your travels have left you more experience, allowing you to advance, blah blah blah. None of these seem particularly suited to creating a path out of this place, but as you sift through them, you know that you are trapped here, not because it is some puzzle your sire left for you to solve, but because you are not yet whole. This is another part, the last part, of deciding who you are. In completing yourself, you will be able to open a path back to the calm of your mind. Okay, we're going to select focus. Cool. So, okay, this one we got Shield Master. In your skilled hands, you can make almost anything a shield. And counterattack. Ends turn immediately. Whenever attack misses you, make a basic attack against that enemy if in range. There's no limit to the number of attacks that can be made this way each turn. You are a patient fighter, willing to wait until the moment is right to strike. Your rivals mistake this for fear. When they test you, you show them why they were wrong. I'm not going to choose this focus. Breathe Shadow Nocturnal. Gain plus 5% on Quick Fingers tasks, Deception tasks, and Perception tasks. The darkness is your ally. You excel at skills suited for the shadows. And Surprise Attack. If this character is hidden or targeting an enemy that is blinded, gain 10% on attacks and plus 3 damage. You strike from the shadows, you seek weakness in your enemies, and you strike first and hardest. And brandishes a silver tongue. You know the right thing to say in every solution. There is no obstacle that cannot be overcome with words. Max effort plus 1 on persuasion, deception, and intimidation tasks. You're a natural leader, a gracious speaker, and gifted with words. People find it easy to relate to you. So this is a persuasion, deception, intimidation. This is quick fingers, deception, perception. I like both of these, but I'm going to take breathe shadows. Because I don't know how to make myself hidden. Not yet, anyway. Ah. That's it! You did it, Kamose says. Villon says, does this mean we can go back to the real world? Diviaticu says, I don't think so, Villon. But it does mean we are free, finally. He turns to you. Thank you, friend. Go. We will follow. He thinks something's not right. Shadows, angles. It's safer for her to go first. It's your mind. You should walk the path. Go ahead. I'd rather make sure it works first. I'm curious to see what awaits us next.
I'm ready.
We're ready. Leave the area to the calm. We're attacked by the thing again. Yes. Ooh. I got shoved through it. Well, I wanted to go there anyway. Isn't it gonna attack the other three now? That's what the sorrow sent those things into my mind. That's the Spectre guy. I saw what happened. Are you alright? That thing almost killed you. What did happen? It blasted you out of that part of your mind. His voice is somber. The sorrow must be gathering its strength, taking spaces in your mind to keep you from reaching your full potential. I don't know why it doesn't just destroy you. Maybe the fragments aren't strong enough. Yet. It's alright, though. We have more important things to do, right? Like get that chamber fixed. Something feels odd about this man, but it takes a while to put your finger on it. It's his thoughts. They aren't there. Or rather, they're there, but they're indistinct. A kind of white noise that blends in too well with the background hush of this place. We have a lot of questions. Are you always here? He shrugs. Where else would I be? I found the resonance chamber, but it's broken. Yeah, I saw that. I don't see anything you do out there in the world, but I definitely saw that. You have to find a way to fix it. Your thoughts are fuzzy. Why can't I read them? His voice is dry, but his smile takes some of the sting from his words. I imagine it's because we're in a place of pure thought. I'm a construct of pure thought, and that our conversation is taking place on the level of thoughts. Most things here aren't real. It'd be like reading your own mind. If this is my mind, why don't I remember this place? I told you as much as I know. It's your mind, and that means you're in control. You just need to figure out how to unlock its secrets. I don't know how, but I think the resonance chamber will do that for us. It'll unite us, make us whole again. Is there anything to do while I'm here? You mean apart from the cabaret acts, distilleries, and endless adventures just beyond the next wrinkle in your mind? He jabs you in the arm with his elbow. Huh, and if you believe that... Sorry, but it's your mind. There's nothing like that here. I've looked. Still, you've changed things plenty already. I wouldn't be surprised if something showed up here eventually. Has anything changed since the last time I was here? He shrugs. Look around. It's your mind. How did activating the clock in the real world open that other fathom? Who knows? It probably triggered something in your mind, made a bridge you didn't have before. Maybe you did have the bridge once, but you lost it. Could other fathoms open like that? Maybe. You've already made a lot of changes to this place. At this point, nothing would surprise me. What should I do now? With the chamber broken, I am not sure. We need to find someone who can fix it. That chamber is our only hope. Without it. How do I get back this time? The portal's still there. I don't see why it wouldn't work twice. Alright. Good luck, etc. Alright. Nothing to do but go through. The portal has collapsed into this tiny pulsing sphere. Something about it strikes you as angry, though you'd be hard-pressed to say why. What's on your mind? Use the portal. I'd love to. Unless there's something down here. Oh, this portal.
Ready.
The swirling depths flicker with mysteries and powers you cannot define. The sorrow shattered the mirror leading back to the dark fathom. Glass shards hiss when you touch them. Okay, so this is the portal.
Go. Much better.
Much better. Oof. We're back. Oh, look at this thing. It actually looks like more like a like a pendulum.
Go.
The machine is solid now. Its three clock faces are fixed on a single point each. The clock's purpose is still a mystery, but at least you can interact with it. You notice that the figures of Kamose, Diviaticu, and Villon are no longer present in the central clock face. They only exist in your labyrinth now. The machine hums and ticks in a steady, droning rhythm. It's definitely a clock of some kind, though it is not measuring time in any way you can understand. The figures that were beneath the central clock face are gone. Oh, you guys have anything to say? You fixed the clock, Kasmin says. I knew you could do it. I knew it. She shoots a triumphant smile at Mimion. You must tell us what you saw. Who were those figures? Were they Castoffs? What did they say? Were you able to retrieve them? Patience, Cass. We must first congratulate our guest. I like that he bows like that when he actually bows. He turns to you. Masterfully done, revered one. A performance worthy of your sire. He bows gravely to you. You are most welcome here. And we do have answers for your questions, revered one. That is, as soon as we hear the report of what you have found. Tell us, Kasmin says. She is nearly breathless with excitement. Should we even tell them? I met Kamose, Diviaticu, and Villon. Disappointment creases her face. Blue tide goes up. A small amount. I know these names. They're not new to us. They were favored servants of your creator, Castoffs who served him well. Indeed, Diviaticu brought the Order of Truth to Sega's Cliffs, but they betrayed their holy trust and disappeared. Mimion sighs. Nevertheless, we will honor our arrangement. You sought answers about who might repair the resonance chamber. We know that your sire built it with the aid of another Castoff, still unknown to us. Perhaps one of your siblings might know where to find him, or her. I know of only one other Castoff still in this city, the albino assassin Matkina. They call her the White Death. She wore a camouflaging cloak and brought destruction in her wake. The last I heard of her, she was in the underbelly. He restrains a shudder. Seek her, but be wary.
I'll remember that.
Farewell, Castoff. I must consult with my colleague. Updated my journal. Oh yeah, the plus thing. I want to increase my stat pools again. You can select each option once per tier. Let's increase these a little bit. I'll go back to intellect next time. That's it? Okay. We're getting close to the next, though. You return, revered one. How may we assist you with... How may we assist you today? Oh, I would like to sleep here. We would be honored if you would... If you chose to stay with us. We do request a small donation of 40 shins to offset our costs. He shrugs. We must rely on donations, even from our revered visitors. I'll pay. I need my abilities back. Rest well. Tiber says, just a reminder, lass. Tiber says, catching your sleeve. Riss will be dead by the day after tomorrow if we don't do anything to save him. Okay. Noted. I'll head to the government section next. Do you have any supplies you could share with me? Share? Oh dear, we are a small group and not wealthy. We exist on donations, curios, and the occasional great gift from one of your siblings. For instance, we had a weapon once used by the Chalcedon. The Chalcedon? The commander of... She catches herself. My point is that we require some payment for our wares. Okay, they have the stuff that I have. And they have a cortical shunt, which is an artifact. Negative effects, minus 3 resistance, plus 1 training and deception skill, plus 2 damage on esoteric attacks. When placed against a user's head, this piece of crooked metal gently thrusts a rod into their brain. Tim, gently, and then thrusts. Doesn't really go that well together. And releases whispering, subtle pulses of an unknown energy. Yes. How much is that? That's pretty expensive. Cool. Anything else? What can you tell me about the beliefs of your church? We tell the world that you and your brethren are aspects of the divine truth of the changing God, and that each of you brings forth a particular facet of his truths. We seek to study you so that we can become more like you. Her teeth gleam as she smiles at you. What are the benefits of joining your church? Mimion steeples his fingers. We can provide our adherents with useful items. We can offer safety against the depredations of those who would harm us as they sleep. Our members may be available to aid each other in specific situations. What can you tell me about the other castoffs? Kasmeen smiles and laughs. We have spent years compiling our records, revered one. I know the time seems as nothing to your kind, but we must protect our knowledge. Perhaps if you were to join our group, provide some of your experience to aid to our knowledge. I'm going to hold off on that. Why can't you tell me more about them? Our secrets are our own, Mimion says. We do not provide them to outsiders. Of course, if you were to join us, you would no longer be an outsider. He bows his head. But I'm a castoff. I'm a revered one. All right. Who did you say could lead me to the repair of the resonance chamber? Kina. Farewell. Farewell, beloved vessel. Does he have anything new to say? Okay, we're kind of at a... That goes to the underbelly, that goes to Government Square. I gotta head there next. After we finish this zone, which might... This might be it.
Yes.
Maybe those things don't work anymore, right? Now that the clock has become fixed in the present time, this device has reverted to its original state. It no longer alters what you can see around you, and there are no images on its surface. Alright. Let's just finish up. This is going to be a two-part episode. I'm just going to fill it out a little bit. Embedded in the cliff wall is a massive structure that clearly predates the buildings that surround it. This skull-like relief could be a warning, or perhaps a notice that something harmless but related to death waits below. And he's going down there.
Yes.
So this is the edge. Oh, there's a mutant here. Oh, and there's autocatons here. Hail, mutant. The sun is nourishing today, is it not? Autocaton. Autocaton, whatever. Gorga, you are drunk. It's boring, this circus. Should go to another bar. It's not a bar. It's too hot here. The sky is too thin. Okay, and there's this bridge across.
Naturally.
Oh, what's this? Subtle energy plays along the cables, though whether to prepare the fish for consumption or deter their theft, you couldn't say. This is the other side we've been over here. I think. We've been here. I guess we can't go in this place. What's down this bridge?
Don't mind if I do.
Did you see the falling star? It landed in the reef, I think. My friend here says that a star fell into the reef. I say it was a moon at most. We stopped short. I hear there's good salvage in the waters down there. Some folks fish for it in the underbelly.
Fine.
Ah, that goes to the cliff's edge. Well, we're done. You know, I wish I could click here, go to that place on the map,
yes,
and then do my click. Town Crier. I don't think we talked to him. Another house collapses in cliff's edge. Council blames the Stitcher. Stitcher. Alright. You feel a slight tugging in the corner of your mind when gazing upon this symbol. Oh, this is one huge city, guys. Does Philethus have anything new to say? He's been watching me. Exquisite.
Fine.
And fine. Damn fine. Damn exquisite. Okay. So next episode, guys, to the government district, government square. We will help, well, eventually, upon exploring the place, we'll help Tibir with his quest, or at least get a little further along. And yeah, fascinated by this game, loving it so far. So much to read. I know some of you guys don't like to hear me read, but you're in the wrong place. So thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and enduring. Grow strong.